Pictures from the fifth edition of the Victor Oche Wheelchair Basketball Championship currently taking place at the Slim Balogun Stadium in Lagos. The game you were watching, Kano taking on Lagos, and Kano went on to win that one. Femi Adefeso joins us now as we approach the final phase of this program. Femi, good to have you join us on the show.
It was a pleasure to be here, Austin.
Well, how does it feel sitting there? Kajetan just left. Is it hot?
Yeah, you can see that again.
Let's talk about the Wheelchair Basketball Championship. With what you've seen, any improvements?
Yes. We just saw Kano. Kano is a new team, Kano Pillars. Mm. You know, we know them for football, we know them for basketball. Now wheelchair basketball.
Fantastic.
You know, so and they're doing very well. You know, they've been able to get a clean sweep and they beat Lagos, you know, in that very game, 39-7.
Wow.
You know, that's how we ended. And it was very emphatic from them. And they are through to the semifinals, no doubt about it. This other game is a duel between Kwara State.
Okay.
Kwara, yes, season campaigners, but the Edo guys are actually been, you know, more brutal in the way they've gone about their games, you know, throughout in this competition so far. But it's been interesting. I must say, but the biggest team has to be Oyo. It looks like all the boys from Lagos moved ship to Oyo, and they say sportsmen go to where the money is.
Oh, yeah?
So I guess Oyo is spending money this year,
mm-hmm.
and they're looking to get the title once again. They've won the championship before, even though it's been talks between Lagos and Oyo winning, you know, the championship in the last 4 years, you know, in between. But the fifth edition also still has the international flair with Ghana, you know, sending in their representatives.
Okay.
Although, you know, usually we have more from Togo and Benin, but this time only Ghana and coming through. But at least it still gives it that flavor. The women too are not left out. You know, the 3-on-3 kida is up for them too.
Fantastic.
You know, as well, and it's been balanced. You know, Ghana wins today, is Imo winning tomorrow.
Okay.
Next one is Delta winning, is Lagos winning in the women's category. So it's been more of, you know, you don't know what to expect, you know, in all of that. And because they are uneven in terms of the number of teams that they, I think 7 numbers, so they made it like a league format, you know, for the women's game.
Mm.
So it's not groups, unlike the guys, which is, you know, grouped into two. So come tomorrow and Saturday, that's when the finals, you know, will take place. But it's been very interesting to watch.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
These guys, what they do is,
God,
it's amazing. It's fast-paced, the way they shoot the ball,
yeah,
you know, even from three-point range. Meanwhile, don't be deceived, it's the same height, you know, with the able-bodied guys.
Wow.
The rim doesn't come later than 10 feet. So it's still
and
the same 10 feet.
Put the ball
and
in
they still manage to put the ball
the
in the basket.
The same hand that he moves, he's usually moving.
Exactly. You know,
this
that's
so amazing.
You know, you're wheeling your chair, and at the same time, you're still trying to outmaneuver the opponent,
you
and then try to pass the ball and shoot the ball. It's fantastic.
Yeah, I try to understand the level of creativity involved in it. That's why we must support special athletes in this country.
Yes, it's compulsory. These guys were very close to qualifying for the Paralympics.
I remember.
They came very close to Nigeria.
Mm.
They got knocked out in the semi-finals by just 1 point. I remember for the for the guys you know, and the ladies too did pretty well too, you know, in there. And they're also preparing for the under 23 championship later in December, and I know a few sparks, you know, have come out of this tournament that they'll be putting into the national selection. But the beautiful part too is also that Nigeria's international players who have come home to also be a part of this, you know, every year, you know, it happens. Lukman Ibrahim is also back in town.
Mm.
You know, he's based in France and he's playing for Team Oyo, wearing jersey 7. He's not on the screen now, but he's playing. Also, last year's most valuable player, I remember him, Musba Oshitu. You know, he couldn't make it down this year. He's now playing in Switzerland, you know, haven't played all the years,
yeah,
you know, in Nigeria. After last year's, you know, stellar performance,
I know,
he's been able to
also,
you know,
let the viewers know that his wife is also,
yes, playing, and she's the reigning most valuable player in the women's category.
What a story.
So I'm sure by the time the final comes on the way, we'll be seeing it. And the beautiful ambience of the new arena, you know, it used to be the National Stadium, now crossing over to the Teslim, you know, Balogun Stadium in support from the Lagos State government. It's been fantastic. They're all enjoying the whole atmosphere,
mm,
you know, behind it. And the finals always come with a little bit of razzmatazz.
Right.
And I've been sampling all the opinions of all the guys and the ladies there, and they're like, we just want to play to win. because, you know, Honorable Victor Oche, who is the patron of the Wheelchair Basketball Federation, you know, always throws in a lot of support, comes yeah. with a lot of his friends, and also the entertainment mm-hmm. angle that comes with it. I remember last year that the Shoki was, you know, yeah, to give them a lot, and he said he was going to come back, you know, so we're looking forward to the return, if possible, if he comes, you know, eventually on Saturday. But even the president of the Federation too, you know, is really, really upbeat by the fact that they were able to pull this off, you know, despite all the economic recession and the fact that it's been difficult to raise funds, you know, for these athletes. But the fact that we are giving, you know, these guys something to look out for every year, you know, is something remarkable. And what next for us is to build on this, perhaps, you know, start a league, you know, which would be sustainable for these guys, and we start competing on the African continent, which already we were powerhouse, although international competitions only gives one ticket.
In 1 minute, that's why in one minute, what team are you tipping for the final?
Wow, it's going to be okay. I'll pick three teams.
Okay.
Kano.
Okay.
Oyo. And Ghana.
Kano, new team.
Yeah.
Are you tipping them for the final?
Yes. Kano, they are also smart. You know, I think they played their cards right in getting some key elements, you know, from yesteryear. So, some more experience and, you know, I've been put in that team, and they look like a team that can really cause an upset.
Mm.
But the Oyo team, the most experienced side, you know, they virtually almost all the players, about 4, 5, 6 of them, you know, just moved ship from Lagos last year, who won, you know, so their experience in terms of winning, you know, the championship, so you can't look no further than champions already. But I think Kano has what it takes, you know, to eventually get a win in this tournament.
That's it. So we'll monitor to see if Femi's prediction will come to pass. It's all about the fifth edition of the Wheelchair Basketball Championship taking place in Lagos. Femi, let's talk about the WNBA finals. We'll be looking out for NECA.
Yeah, Nneka Ogumike, the reigning most valuable player of the women's
say that again.
Yeah, WNBA, and she was also picked as the defensive player of the year as well. So it's becoming, you know, more like a breakout season for her, and it will be a perfect season, you know, if she ends up getting the WNBA title too. Remember, she was drafted number one pick in 2014, you know, so in relatively just 2 years, you know, she was able to power her team to their first WNBA final since 2003.
Wow.
You know, but they're going to be facing a very difficult foe in the Minnesota Lynx, you know, who have been champions 4 times in the last 6 years,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they have the reigning most valuable player in Maya Moore, one of the stars of the U.S. Women's National Team. But the big statement here definitely is the fact that Nneka and her teammate Candace Parker, who has been highly rated, were two of the star names in the WNBA that were dropped by the U.S. national team. So everybody is talking, you know, about the fact that, look, these girls actually deserved, you know, to be in that Olympic triumph. But now they are showing it with the way they are playing,
yeah.
you know, the court at the moment. The first two games will be away in Minnesota, you know, on Sunday, like you said,
yeah.
and on Tuesday, October 11th, while they play the second two games in Los Angeles. And if there's a need for a tiebreaker in game 5, to go back to Minnesota, you know, for them. But I like the fact that it's evenly poised.
Yeah.
During the regular season, they met 4 times. The Los Angeles team won 2,
yeah.
and the Minnesota Lynx won 2. Mm. So it will be very interesting to watch. And I hope this lady eventually crowns up what has been a fantastic season.
You can say that,
you know, with the WNBA title.
Right.
For the first time in our career.
Thank you so much, Femi, at the first one. That wraps up the discussion. I appreciate you coming around. And of course, to you, wherever you're in the world watching Sports Tonight on Channels TV, let's not stop the conversation. Keep talking to us. On behalf of the team, I'm Austin Okunafani. Everything you do, remember, keep talking sports. Bye for now.